Hi, I'm Jen. I'm going to walk you through my analytics career path, starting with getting hired as an analyst, moving through other analytical roles, and then taking a director level position in a large international corporation. I hope that my analytics career journey will inspire you to think outside the box about the path that your own career could take. It might give you some ideas of areas you hadn't thought of before and help you craft where you want to go on your analytics journey. If you're exploring your career or you're ready to take the next steps at getting a new job, check back each week. We post twice a week videos here at the Career Force, focusing on everything related to analytics careers. I've always liked data, facts, and logical problems, so it made a lot of sense when I decided to become an analyst for my career. My educational background is a bachelor's degree in math with a minor in economics, so a lot of numbers, but also a lot of logic. What a lot of people don't realize is that upper level math classes really are as much about the logical reasoning as they are about any numbers or letters. My first career position after college was as a data analyst. So in that position, I did a lot of data analysis, data science work, but also a lot of business analysis type work. So that's going to vary a little bit position to position. Different companies implement these roles in different ways. For me, it was a lot of problem solving, given different things to look at and come up with solutions. So I really enjoyed that work. There were a few things that I focused on in this position, which I think really helped me prepare for the next position I'd take. The first is I really built up my programming skills. I unfortunately didn't go into this position knowing how to do much programming, but I self-taught a lot of SAS as well as some other programming languages, but SAS was the main language used at the company I was working for at the time. So I worked on that. The other big thing that I spent a lot of time on and has benefited me throughout my career is really building up my network. Especially when you're new to a company or to the working world in general, you need to build your connections. You're gonna find so much information from these people, and you'll probably find that a lot of them are really willing to help you out and help you take the next steps in your career. So I built my network. I also looked for opportunities for leadership. And while I wasn't managing anyone, there were always opportunities where I could take responsibility for something that was maybe normally outside of my scope, but would help out the team or help out the company and really show those around me that I was willing to go outside of my day-to-day boxed-in job responsibilities and really make things happen. Within a year, I was promoted. I took on a role in a financial analyst position focused mainly on warranty. So for those that aren't familiar, it's really similar to the insurance industry. You're trying to predict what's going to happen and how much it's going to cost so that you can make sure that you're properly charging for things and you're properly reserving the right amount of money. I spent a lot of time focusing on my predictive analytics skills here and got really good at it. I was able to do predictions that were having error rates of less than 2%, which is pretty good for anyone that's done predictions. You know, it can be difficult to be that accurate. So I spent a lot of time building those skills, also working on my data visualization skills so that I could communicate with the rest of the business team. This business analyst, financial analyst role wasn't something that was common information to the rest of the organization. While there certainly were other people doing this type of work, there were a lot of people that it was kind of magic behind the scenes as to how it got done. So it was really important to be able to communicate the results. I also looked for opportunities to, again, take on more leadership roles. So for me, this meant taking leadership classes. It meant getting involved in some organizational development activities and really taking extra time that stretched my workday to be able to really go into the organization and lead and build my network. And that paid off huge. The next position, which was actually within a year of that promotion, was moving into a manager role. I was managing the financial analysts and data analysts with regards to warranty and quality. So in that role, I still worked on my technical skills, but I also got a chance to manage analysts. I had a lot of fun doing that work. It's really good when you're in a good team of analysts, the camaraderie that's built and the way that you can bounce ideas off of each other and find new ways to solve different problems. So in that role, I continued to build my skills. I focused more on data visualization, more on communication, because a lot of the activities I was doing were going to higher and higher levels. They were going to the board members of the organization. They were going to the CEO of the organization. So it really had to be accurate, clear, and concise, because it was rarely me delivering the information. I might have to pass it up a few levels of the organization and give that person enough information that they could really talk articulately about what was going on. The other thing I did at this point in my career was I got more involved in the industry. There's a lot of organizations for pretty much any industry you can think of. So in my case, I got more involved in the warranty industry and specifically in the warranty analytics industry. I spoke at conferences, I wrote papers, I got connected with the people that made the software, and this really helped me learn a lot, but it also gave me, in some cases, information as to what tools might be coming out. It let me give feedback to the software makers about what I saw could be done in the business. And the other thing I did was I helped build different training. So training on financial predictions and financial analysis, data modeling that has been implemented in the industry. So at this point in my career, I was about 4.5 years out of college. I was on my third position and getting ready to transition to my fourth. I don't think this type of career growth would have been possible without me having some fundamental strong background in analytics and being able to do the logical work that came with it. But the other thing that has been a huge help throughout my career is being willing to step up and do more, to stretch, to grow myself, to make connections with people. This goes a long way to helping you take steps in your career, even when you don't see what that position might be. With both of the positions I just talked about after my first one, they didn't, in some cases, even exist until they were created for me. And it came about largely because I was doing stuff outside of my comfort zone. I was going above and beyond. So don't just look at it as what's the next position I'm going to be in. It's great to plan ahead, but also do things without expecting something in return in your career. And they're gonna be noticed. Your managers are gonna notice. Managers around you are gonna notice. It really stands out when people are doing an exceptional job. And it really is noticed when people aren't just doing the minimum that they can do to get by. All of these skills definitely didn't come naturally to me at first. While I definitely like experimenting with different things and solving problems, I'm not naturally much of an extrovert. So it takes energy for me to go out and talk with other people. And connecting with other people doesn't mean that you need to be buddy-buddy or really personal about things. You can still talk about work and be friendly with people and grow that network. It'll really serve you a long way in the future. And even if you change companies, that doesn't mean your network at the old company is doing you a disservice. They can still be people that you reach out to as resources. They can vouch for you for future positions. It's a great network to have. So after all of that, the next position, so we're on the fourth position now and about 4.5 years out of college, I moved into a global role. And this was really interesting because I had always been at a global company, but I was always focused a little more locally. So in this role, I became part of an executive management team across 7 different sites globally. So we were in the majority of the major time zones that are out there. And in this role, I focused a lot on process improvement and on analytics. So one of the beautiful skills that you have if you're a good analyst is you're very process driven and you're very logical about how you can solve problems. So in this role, I was able to do a lot of work to standardize globally how we were working. I worked with analysts in all of these sites. I was able to streamline some different things. So identify best practices in different sites, combine them, take the best of everything and really implement implement them so that we could globally have the best result. Again, I think this is something that came from networking and building my skills, going out and doing above and beyond what my job called for. So I might be working with someone in the US on site face-to-face in the afternoon, and then the next morning I might be working with someone who's 12 time zones away from me. So it's a great chance to build both your knowledge of how people work, but also your communication skills, because there are differences in how we communicate across cultures and how we properly convey information. There's also so much to be learned from working with a wide variety of people, and with companies becoming increasingly global, it's a fantastic skill to have. You need to be able to communicate well, both in writing and when you're talking with people and in your visualization of data, even if someone's not right there with you. It's sometimes nice to be able to write on a whiteboard all your logic for how you solved a problem, but other times you might need to be able to articulate the exact steps you followed fairly simply and in writing to someone that maybe it's not convenient to actually call. So again, in this role, one of the things I did was look at the industry and what I could do. It was some connection still with this global training, with the industry training and knowledge, but it was also getting involved with graduate analytics programs and helping walk students that were going to become analysts through solving different business specific problems. I think this is a great skill for people entering a new career to have. If you haven't ever taken the time to solve a business problem, there's probably going to be more of a learning curve. What I've found in working with analysts and hiring analysts is ones that are recently out of school with no business application often are fantastic at applying research methods, but they might struggle a little bit with the ambiguity that often comes with business questions. So getting some real world business practice in can be really good for you, even if you don't have a specific business problem. Take a problem that you do have where you don't know all the information and apply those analytical skills to it. I held this position in my global role for about 4 years, and then after that I took on a director role within the warranty organization. So my responsibilities were for everything produced in North America, which was a very large part of the business that I was a part of. I had a team that spanned two different sites within the US. There was a lot that went back to those communication skills and those networking skills that I had built early on in my career. I managed teams of analysts in that position, trying to solve different problems, trying to identify problems of what might be going on before they became big problems. I also did a lot with negotiating with suppliers, both contracts and settlements for different financial issues. And for me, this is where my analytic skills again came in handy. I can logically reason through a problem, I can build a logical case, and that's a great skill to have in negotiation related roles. So it might not be immediately obvious how an analyst would move into a director role that was more focused on suppliers and negotiation, which is the role that I ended up in, but there were lots of steps along the way that led me to that point and allowed me to be extremely successful in that role. Something you might be wondering is, what kind of connections did I have that got me these jobs? And the truth is, not many. This was a job I found and applied for, and then my skills and the value that I was adding to the company helped propel me further along in my career. So while I've certainly had a lot of things that I've been fortunate to give me advantages, I didn't have anyone waiting to hand me a job. I applied for the job, I wrote a resume, I built my skills, I learned about the industry, and all of these things really helped propel me forward in my career. Why am I not in that director role today? Well, I really want to switch gears and help other people experience the same success that I have. I truly believe there are a lot of really skilled people out there, especially in the analytics world, that maybe just need a little help finessing their resume, finessing their approach to their career path, so they can build themselves a successful career. So if that sounds sounds like you, I'd love to connect with you and help you. If you're not quite to the point where you're ready to work with me one-on-one, I do have a guide that'll walk you through my top steps to growing your career, and you can get that in the link below. But if you are ready to work with me one-on-one and grow your career, I would love to talk with you about how I could help you through that. I'll link below so you can connect with me or reach out to me on LinkedIn and we can talk about what I can do to help you have the same career success.